Hello students, welcome to my class. Today we are going to discuss equations of the uniformly accelerated motion by calculus method. So in kinematics, we have the motion and some equations related to the motion. Using the calculus method, you are going to derive these equations. The four basic equations related to motion are these four equations. First is v is equal to u plus at. Second is s is equal to ut plus half at square. Third equation is v square is equal to u square plus 2as. And the fourth equation is s is equal to u plus v by 2 into t. So understand the terms here in this equation. V is nothing but my final velocity. U is initial velocity. S is displacement, A is acceleration, and T is time. So these are the terms given used here. So one more basic thing that we have to understand is velocity V equal to displacement by time. Displacement is s, no? So it is change in displacement by change in time. And acceleration can be acceleration a is equal to velocity by time. That is also again change in velocity by change in time. And this acceleration can also be written with respect to displacement as, see, acceleration is equal to change in velocity by change in time. And we know that velocity is equal to change in displacement by change in time. So have this d by dt as such. And for v, you can write it as ds by dt. So this is nothing but twice the differentiation. So it is d square s by dt square. So which is called double differentiation. This is single differentiation or first differentiation. This is double differentiation. That is, if you have the displacement, if you differentiate that displacement twice, you will get the acceleration value. If your displacement is differentiated once, you will get the velocity value. So this is the basic understanding to proceed with the equations. So let us proceed with the equations. First, we are going to relate the velocity with time. So what is that velocity with time related? Velocity by time. Change in velocity by change in time. What is that? It is nothing but my acceleration a. So I have a equal to dv by dt. Let me bring this dt to the other side. It becomes dv equal to a into dt. Now you have dv equal to a into dt. So integrate this on both sides so as to get the value. The equation should be only v a something like that. So I am going to integrate on both sides. So integrating this, integral dv is equal to integral a into dt. Here the differentiable part is t. So the limits is from 0 time to time t. Here for this velocity, from the initial velocity to the final velocity. The change is from the initial value to the final value. Initial value to be the upper lower limit and final value to be the upper limit. So integral of dx is simply x. Similarly, integral of dv is simply v. And again, integral of dt is simply t. So integral of dv is nothing but v. So it is v, and you have to substitute the lower limits here first. So first integrate it and then substitute the limits. So I have given the limits here. So a is not different integrable, only the dt part is integrable. A is a constant here. So take the a value outside. So it is a integral of 0 to t into dt. So it is integral, v from the initial velocity u to v, which is equal to a integral of 0 to t dt. And let me have it as such for this case. Then a integral of dt is t, and you have the limits here 0 to t. Now substitute the limits. You have to go for upper limit first and then minus lower limit instead of this. So upper limit, instead of v, you have to substitute the upper limit. Here again it is v. So it is v minus, instead of this v, lower limit. So lower limit. So upper limit minus lower limit. And then a into upper limit minus lower limit. So it is v minus u is equal to a into t minus 0 is simply t. So we have got v minus u is equal to a t. Bring this u to the other side. It would become v equal to u plus a t. So this is my first equation of accelerated motion. So for the second case of equation, I'm going in for displacement time relationship. So displacement time is, see, it is change in displacement by change in time. What is the change in displacement, change in time? It is called velocity. So velocity v is equal to change in displacement by change in time. As of the same case, bring this t dt to the other side, it becomes v into dt is equal to ds. I am writing it in the inverse. So ds is equal to v into dt. Again, integrate on both sides. So you would get integral ds is equal to integral v into dt. Here for time, so the limits are 0 to t. Because time will be varying from the 0 time, right? So the displacement is from the 0 point to, yes, displacement. Displacement is change in the distance, right? It is from 0 point, it is starting and it is moving to some distance called s. So displacement called s. So it is 0 to s ds, which is equal to integral 0 to t v into dt. So now here, let me have it as ds. 0 to s, which is equal to, this v is not differentiable or integrable, only this dt is integrable, because this is what is differentiated value. So bring this v as the outside, as it is constant, integral 0 to t dt. We know ds is simply s, integration of ds is s. So 0 to s limits, which is equal to v as such, integration of dt is t. So t 0 to, substitute the limits now, upper limit minus lower limit. So instead of this s, I have to go for upper limit. Upper limit is also s. So it is s minus 0, which is equal to v into upper limit minus lower limit, t minus 0. So s minus 0 is s, and v into t minus 0 is t. So we have it like this, and in this equation, instead of v, I am going to substitute the equation v equal to u plus at in the first, we have derived in the first equation, right? I am going to substitute this first equation here instead of v. So I will be writing it as 0 to s integral ds is equal to integral 0 to t. Instead of this v, it is u plus at. So u plus at into dt. This I can split and write, because it is plus only, no? I can write it as u dt plus at dt. So it is 0 to s integral ds is equal to integral 0 to t u dt plus integral 0 to t at dt. I am just splitting it off and writing separately. Yeah, okay. So now let me go into the integration now. Before that, let me take the constant terms outside. So integral 0 to s ds is equal to, here u is constant, just take it outside of the integration, only t is differentiable. So 0 to t dt. Here you have one more t. So t dt should be inside the integral, and bring this a alone out of the integration. So it is 0 to t t dt. So we know that integration of dt is t, and integration of t into dt is t square by 2. Because if it is integral x into dx, the formula is x power, if it is x power n, the formula is x power n plus 1 by n plus 1. X power n is dot dx is equal to, formula is x power n plus 1 by n plus 1, the integration value. If it is x power 1 into dx, then it is x power 1 plus 1 by 1 plus 1, that is x square by 2. If it is x square into dx, x power 2 plus 1 by 2 plus 1, that is x cube by 3. If you have something like this, you have to add 1 power and divide it by that number is the integration value. So here you have, it is t into dt. Then the integration value is, you have to add up 1 power. Here t power 1. So t square divided by that number 2. So integral t dt value is t square by 2. This is the formula of integration. So for this term, you have to go for t square by 2. And for this term, t, for this integral of ds is s. So when you do that here, integral of ds is s and the limits are 0 to s. And u as such, integral of t is, dt is t and the limit 0 to t, plus a as such, integral of t dt is t square by 2 and the limits are 0 to t. Now substitute the limits, you will be getting as s minus 0 upper limit minus lower limit is equal to u into upper limit minus lower limit plus a into upper limit minus lower limit. 0 by 2, simply 0. So it is s minus 0 is s, u into t plus a into t square by 2, which can be written as s is equal to ut plus, bring this 1 by 2 outside, so it is 1 by 2 at square. This is my second equation of motion. S is equal to ut plus half at square. So we are going for the third derivation. For third derivation, velocity time is over and displacement time is over. Now we are going for velocity and displacement relationship, which is dv by ds, change in velocity by change in displacement. This one is not directly available. For that, I'm going in for the equation of acceleration. We know that it is dv by dt, because in the numerator I want dv, so I'm taking this as the base equation. Okay, so in the numerator you'll have dv only for the acceleration. So a is equal to dv by dt. I'm replacing this equation like this. See, dv by ds into ds by dt, because this ds ds will get cancelled off and you will get same dv by dt, right? So I'm going to change this equation like this, so as I'll get this term dv by ds. So what is this ds by dt? Ds by dt is nothing but displacement by time, that is velocity. Velocity is equal to displacement by time. So in for this term, I'm going to replace it as the velocity v. So acceleration a is equal to dv by ds into the velocity v. So this is how you relate the velocity with displacement. Now again, as of in the previous case, bring this ds to the other side, and I'm, for this term I'm bringing this a also to the, I'm just replacing these two terms. So ds is equal to, if you bring this a to the other side, it becomes 1 by a into v into dv. This will be slightly different in your book. Just follow this and understand this. So it is ds is equal to 1 by a into v into dv. Now what we have to go in for, we have to integrate on both sides. So when you integrate, it is integral ds is equal to integral 1 by a into v dv. So it is for velocity. If it is for velocity, it is always from initial velocity to final velocity. And for displacement, it is always 0 to s, the limits. So when you have this ds as such, bring the constant terms outside first. So here v 1 by a is constant, only v dv is differentiable because velocity is what is integrating now. So this v dv is completely integrable. So bring this 1 by a alone outside. You will have integral v dv and the limits are u to v. So integral ds is simply s. You have to substitute the limits here. And 1 by a as such, integral of v dv, as I said, for integral t dt, you have got it as t square by 2, no? So you have one term here. So you have to give the same term, add up the power 1. So it is v power 1. So it is 1 plus 1 becomes 2, v square by 2. And the velocities are, sorry, and the limits are u to v. Integral v dv is v square by 2 and the limits u to v. Now substitute the limits here. It is upper limit minus lower limit is equal to 1 by 2 of, instead of this v, you have to go substitute the limits here. It is instead of v, go for this v. So it is v square by 2 minus lower limit. Lower limit is u. So instead of v, substitute it as u. U square by 2. So you have, it is 1 by a here. This a as such, okay. So it is s is equal to 1 by a into v square minus u square by 2. It is common denominator, so you can write it as v square minus u square by 2. So now what you have, s is equal to 1 by a into v square minus u square by 2, right? So this can be written as this 2a, bring to the other side. If you bring these terms to the other side, it would become multiplication, right? So it is s into 2 into a, which is 2as is equal to v square minus u square. So bring this u to the other term, other side, it is 2as plus u square is equal to v square. That is v square is equal to u square plus 2as. This is my third equation of motion. So for the fourth equation, I'm going to relate two equations. So equation number 1 and 2. So what is the equation number 1? It is v is equal to u plus at. From this, I'm replacing this equation as I'm having at alone, bring this u to the other side. Then it would become at is equal to v minus u. So this equation is first. So next, the second equation is s is equal to ut plus half at square. Let me take this as a, this as b, and substitute this a in b here. Instead of this at, substitute it as v minus u. So if it is so, s is equal to ut plus, this I am going to write it as c, half a t square is split as t into t. Okay. Instead of this a t alone, you are going to substitute this in the equation. Let it be b here. I am going to substitute this in the b now. Instead of this a t alone, I am going to substitute v minus u. So s is equal to u t plus half into, instead of a t, v minus u. V minus u into t. Okay. Just multiply the terms inside now. So it is s is equal to ut plus 1 by 2 into vt minus ut. Multiply this 1 by 2 also inside. So you will get s is equal to ut plus 1 by 2 vt minus 1 by 2 ut. So in these terms, you have ut, ut common, no? So you can write it as s is equal to, write this alone separately, ut minus 1 by 2 ut plus 1 by 2 vt. I just So here I have just replaced this terms here. Rearrange the terms here. So it is S is equal to, see in this you can take UT as common, 1 minus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 VT. So S is equal to UT into 1 minus 1 by 2 is 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 VT. So then S is equal to 1 by 2 UT plus 1 by 2 VT. Here you can take T and 1 by 2 common. So I have taken the 2, 1 by 2 common, then it is U plus V and T common outside. See, if you multiply 1 by 2 U into this T, 1 by 2 VT plus 1 by 2 into V into T, 1 by 2 VT. So my S is equal to, I can write this equation as U plus V into T by 2. So the S displacement is equal to U plus V into T by 2. This is my fourth final equation of the equations of kinematics. So what are the final four equations of motion? Equations of uniformly accelerated motion. What are the equations? First equation, what we have derived is V is equal to U plus AT. And the second equation is S is equal to UT plus half AT square. And the third equation is V square is equal to U square plus 2AS. And the final fourth equation is S is equal to U plus V into T by. So these are the equations. I hope you have understood. Please subscribe to my channel.